हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू ई पाठशाला. आई एम वीनत, वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ सोशियोलॉजी, पोस्ट ग्रेजुएट गवर्नमेंट कॉलेज फॉर गर्ल्स, सेक्टर 11, चंडीगढ़. टुडे विल टॉक अबाउट द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ नियो कलोनियलिज्म. द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ नियो कलोनियलिज्म डेवलप्ड इन 20th सेंचुरी, एंड वी कैन अंडरस्टैंड दिस टर्म बाय स्प्लिटिंग इट इंटू इट्स टू वर्ड्स, दैट इज नियो एंड कलोनियलिज्म. टर्म नियो रेफर्स टू समथिंग न्यू, एंड कलोनियलिज्म रेफर्स टू द एज ओल्ड प्रैक्टिस दैट एग्जिस्टेड इन आर इन द वर्ल्ड, विच वॉज अबाउट द पावरफुल नेशंस एक्साइजिंग कंट्रोल ओवर द वीकर नेशंस. वी ऑल नो दैट यूरोपियन कंट्रीज हैव काइंड ऑफ क्रिएटेड देयर कॉलोनीज इन एशियन एंड अफ्रीकन कंट्रीज एंड रूल्ड फॉर ऑलमोस्ट 100 एंड मे इन सम कंट्रीज इवन मोर फॉर मोर ईयर्स. And however, after World War II, most of these countries got freedom and they became independent nations. And it was felt that actually they have become independent nations economically and politically both. But lately, it was realized that despite after attaining this independence, they are still being controlled by their former colonial powers. And the powerful countries, which we call as developed countries now, are exercising their control on their former colonies, and they have devised new mechanisms and new kinds of methods to retain their dominance. We will focus on the following learning objectives: the meaning of neocolonialism, approaches to neocolonialism, and various instruments of neocolonialism. The policy of imperialism or colonialism was pursued by European countries in Asia and Africa for almost three centuries. The policy involved establishment, maintenance, acquisition, and expansion of territories. Parent state would claim sovereignty over the colony, creating of unequal relations between the colonials and the indigenous populations. France, Britain, and Dutch were the most dominating powers with their colonies in many countries in Asia and Africa. However, after the First and the Second World War, the economies of the powerful countries were shattered. There was much outrage amongst the indigenous people in the colonies for independence. Ultimately, these colonies were freed politically. This process was called as decolonization. Decolonization first happened in Asian countries and lately in African countries, which we call as with the freeing of these colonies. In the literal sense, the colonialism ended, but it was realized that the imperialistic ideology has not ended with this political independence. New ways of exercising dominance and control have started emerging by the former colonial powers, addressed as a different kind of colonialism. Neocolonialism emerged in late 20th century as the post-colonial criticism of developed countries for over-involvement in the developing worlds after World War II, even after they attained political independence and sovereignty. International economic, political, and cultural arrangements created predominantly by developed world in the name of development and economic prosperity is nothing but an attempt to still exercise power and dominance over their former colonies, resulting in a new kind of imperialism, that is by and large similar to the classical European colonialism that prevailed in 16th and 17th centuries. This idea of neocolonialism emerged and gained popularity in African nations first. Kwame Nkrumah, the leader of newly independent Ghana, was the first to reflect upon this idea in his book, The Last Stage of Imperialism, in 1965. And before that, Franz Fanon also, in his study that was conducted in 1963, The Wretched of the Earth on Effects of Colonialism, has quoted that centuries will be needed to humanize this world which has been forced down to animal level by imperial powers. Various scholars who talk about neocolonialism have highlighted some examples of the neocolonial practices that are happening in different parts of the world. For example, intervention of US military in the Gulf and the Horn of Africa, structural dependency in the Caribbean and Latin America, continuing racial oppression and unrest in South Africa, Asia, the Pacific, and the Middle East, The global hegemonies exercised by multinational companies and information industries that belong to superior nations. So now we shall talk about the approaches to neocolonialism. The first one is Marx's perspective. Marx viewed capitalism as the root cause for all exploitation, and Marxian perspective links colonialism with the capitalist system, which has led to uneven development. According to Marxist historians, the colonies ruled by Western European countries led indigenous people deprived of opportunities. From a Marxian perspective, former colonies in the post-colonial times serve as avenues for exploiting raw materials and new investment opportunities for capital accumulation of the powerful nations. Another approach to neocolonialism is dependency theory. This approach is built upon Marxist thought, considering neocolonialism as the reason for impoverishment in the world. The proponents of the theory, both from developed and developing nations, argue that there is center of wealthy states and periphery of poor. The resources are sourced from the periphery, and economic prosperity attained from extracting these resources flows in the center, and this is how the countries develop at an uneven rate. Dependency theory states that the underdevelopment of the global south is a direct result of the development of the global north. Another approach to neocolonialism is world systems theory. The world systems theory states that neocolonialism creates unequal economic relations within the world system. Sociologist Emmanuel Wallerstein divides world economic system into three categories, namely core, semi-peripheral, and peripheral countries. Core countries comprise of countries with dominant capitalism, with high levels of industrialization and urbanization. For example, the US, Japan, and Germany. Peripheral countries include the low-income countries, largely agrarian, characterized by very little industrialization, high unemployment, and low literacy levels. These countries are dependent upon core countries for capital. Most of the African countries are included in category of peripheral countries. Semi-peripheral countries have the intermediate position. These are less developed than the core countries, but are more developed than the peripheral nations. Countries like India, Brazil, Mexico, and Nigeria, etc., are the examples of semi-peripheral nations. The last approach to neocolonialism is cultural theory. Proponents of this theory opine that one aspect of neocolonialism is cultural. They believe that the wealthy nations exercise control through the cultural means like media, language, religion, and education for economic gains. They argue that the legacy that colonial powers have left behind is the notion that their ways and cultural traits are superior to the indigenous ways. So, the prevailing ideology that the developed world is superior is supportive for these nations to breach and intervene in the underdeveloping nations and market their cultural practices too in economic interests and excise domination. So, therefore, now we'll talk about various instruments used by these countries to practice neocolonialism. The first one is political interference and formation of puppet governments. In the newly emerged sovereign states, the former imperialist powers have their loyal groups who have been keen on seeking positions of power. With the help of these groups, the former imperial powers have been able to influence the state policies. Many examples of these kinds are found in the countries of Africa and Middle Asia. Francophrique is the term used to explain the scenario which is happening in Africa. It refers to the existence of relationship between some leaders in Africa with President of France and top officials, resulting in indirect French control. The book Cruel Hand on Cameroon, Autopsy of Decolonization by Mongo Betty highlights the post-colonial state of Cameroon and the dominance of French even after attaining freedom. another instrument that has been called as the instrument used by the superior powers to practice neocolonialism is supply of weapons. The security, both internal and external threats, has been the problem for all the newly emerged states. This dependency on the powerful states is used by them as a means to exercise control over their former colonies. Another kind of instrument is financial aids and loans. In post-colonial times, the newly emerged states face economic backwardness, and it made them dependent on their former parent states and developed countries for financial support. Loans are offered by the powerful nations with certain conditions imposed. The international economic institutions like World Bank, International Bank for Reconstruction and Development, and International Monetary Fund, etc., evolved in post-colonial times for control and regulation of world economies, are also used as instruments of exercising dominance. Multinational corporations. In order to control the economic and industrial enterprise at the global level, the corporate companies of developed nations have established a network in less developed countries. These MNCs secure large amounts of profits from the countries where they are placed, consequently benefiting their parent states. They are doing well for their own state and, on the other hand, exploiting the huge natural and human resource in the less developed countries. Security pacts and treaties. This is the practice of creating superpower hegemonies that further helps in creating favorable conditions for influence and dominance. This is done through signing pacts of defense and friendship, largely amongst the powerful nations. North Atlantic Treaty Organization was the first of this kind, signed between USA and powerful European countries in 1949 as an attempt to check Soviet expansion. NATO was critiqued by Soviet Union and was named Coalition of Aggressors to establish Anglo-American domination over the world. Other such coalitions are SEATO, Southeast Asia Treaty Organization, Manila Pact amongst Southeast Asian countries in 1954, Collective Defense Treaty, Baghdad Pact, later called as CENTO, Central Treaty Organization, a treaty between Middle East nations where America, without being the member, has agreed to participate in economic and military activities. These pacts and treaties create a situation whereby the superpowers collectively emerge stronger and even exercise military control on the poorer nations. Another instrument of neo-colonial practice is transfer of technology. In the developing nations, there is severe need for advancing industry and technology. They are not self-sufficient in establishing their own technological base. This becomes another opportunity for the developed nations to keep an upper hand and be in superior positions. Most of technology that is sent to third world by the developed nations is obsolete. In the name of providing assistance for setting industries in the third world by the developed nations is in many ways beneficial to the imperialist nations only. Another instrument that is used for neocolonialism is encouraging of brain drain. Imperialist countries do not aim at developing higher educational and research avenues in the third world. They encourage students from the developing countries to take professional trainings in the areas which serve the needs of the imperialist powers. The people trained in Western culture, outlook and aspirations become ineffective in the underdeveloped environment for their own country. So let us summarize by saying that after World War II, the world got fragmented into two categories, the developing countries and the developed countries. Developed countries are the ones who were the former imperialist nations, and the developing are the ones who got independence from their colonial powers, and they felt that they could go independently their own way. But ironically, the former colonial powers continued to exercise their control on the weaker nations, the developing nations, and they are using instruments like technology, like supplying weapons, and then and then giving social in the name of security, brain drain, etc. And this ongoing scenario is neocolonialism. Thank you.